During this video lecture, I will explain bada's base namespace. The base class of the base namespace is the object class. The object class is the base class of all bada classes, except those with only static methods. The object class provides the equal and the getHashCode functions. The equal function returns true if two objects are the same. The getHashCode function returns the address of the object in the current implementation. In the base namespace, the wrapper classes for C++ types are implemented. The following integral types have been implemented: boolean, int 8, short, character, integer, long, and long. The float and double floating point types have been implemented. Additionally, the string, buffer, and ByteBuffer types have been implemented so that they can be used for arrays. Also, the DateTime, TimeSpan, and UUID types have been implemented. Let's take a look at the string type in more detail. Basically, in bada, a string is a sequence of Unicode characters. The content and the length of the sequence can be changed. So if a string is created without specifications, 16 bytes are allocated by default. After that, if the string length is changed, as much as 1.5 times the actually required memory is allocated. The maximum length of a string is 2 to the 32nd power minus 1 bytes. The primitive functions provided for the string class includes functions to clear the string and to identify whether the string is empty, such as the clear and isEmpty functions. In addition, the getCapacity function can be used to get the size of the allocated memory, and the insureCapacity and setCapacity functions can be used to set the capacity of a string. Also, the getLength and setLength functions to acquire and set the length of the actual string are also provided. Now, to use a string, you have to first initialize the string. You can initialize a string with an existing ASCII string or Unicode string. In addition, if you want to create a string with a capacity greater than 16 bytes, you can create a string by specifying the capacity of the string. I'd like to explain the string functions that can be used to acquire a character pointer or character. As I described previously, since a string is basically a Unicode character sequence, you can handle a string as an mchar type that is used to save Unicode characters. For example, I declared an mchar type variable ch and created the string using a C string made with an ASCII string. Here, I retrieve the 7th character using the square brackets operator, and character s is saved in the variable ch. So you can use the getCharAt function to perform the same functionality as the square brackets operator. The getPointer function is used to acquire the mchar pointer to the string. To change a character in a string, you can use setCharAt or the square brackets operator. In addition, the format function is provided that corresponds to the sprintf function in the conventional C language. The first parameter specifies the maximum length of the string, and the other parameters are the same as those of the sprintf function. So in addition, you can assign a string to another string. Operator plus equals and operator plus are provided to allow appending a string to another string. In addition, an append function is provided, which can be used to append a string to another string, or to convert an integer value or a floating point type into a string type, and append the converted string to a string. In this example, I have created a string containing 10 plus 10. I append the equals string to the string using the operator plus equal and append an integer type value to the string to complete the numeric expression. In addition, you can perform a binary plus operation for a string. The insert function can be used to insert a string into the middle of a string. The usage of this function is the same as that of the append function. Functions to handle substrings within a string are also provided. First, you can use the substring function to acquire a substring from a string. You can use the replace function to replace a substring with another substring. And you can replace a substring with another substring by specifying the substring to be replaced as the first parameter and the new string required as the second parameter. The remove function enables removing a substring from a string. Functions to compare the contents of strings are provided, such as the compare to, equals, starts with, and ends with functions. In addition, the index of and last index of functions can be used to identify if a string contains a specific substring or to find the position of a substring in a string. The toLower and toUpper functions can be used to change the characters of a string to upper or lower case characters. And the reverse function can be used to reverse the order of the characters of a string. This example illustrates how to modify the contents of a string by using various string functions. First, I created a string, a string, and changed the first character of the string to the capital character A. Printing the result will display a string on the screen. And after that, I appended a substring is cool to the string using the append function. As a result, the string has been changed to a string is cool. After that, I inserted a substring class into the ninth character position of the string. The substring class is inserted between string and is. As a result, the string has been changed to a string class is cool. Then, I called a function to remove two characters from the first character position. It removes the a and the blank space. After that, I inserted the into the first character position using the insert function. And the result is the string class is cool. After that, I have created another new string. I initialized this string using the format function. The initialized string is 5 plus 2 is. Then I appended an integer type constant 3 to the string. Then I called the index of function to acquire the index of the plus character in the string and change the character to minus. Then I found the is substring and replaced it with equal. As a result, the str2 string becomes 5 minus 2 equals 3. The last statement appends str2 to the str by using the operator plus equal.